Okay. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, morning. Are you all well? Yeah? Had a good night rest? Okay, excellent. So then let's start, as we always do, start the day in a good way by doing some meditation together. So let's get going here. All right, so again, coming back to some of the very basic ideas of meditation practice, and often it is nice to just think about meditation in the right way, and often not using the word meditation can be useful, thinking of it instead as a rest time, a time to relax, a time to be at ease, and one way of doing that is to just to imagine yourself, you know, sitting in your favorite armchair and just relaxing. Yeah? And as you're relaxing in the favorite armchair, you're just allowing the world to flow by. Yeah? And you're just observing the world as it flows by, yeah? Not controlling it, allowing it to be. Yeah? Because after all, you are just resting what you're doing. Yeah? And as you keep on resting in this way, allowing the world to flow, then the mindfulness sometimes becomes gradually established. And on the way, we will just do a little bit of the nudging of the mind. But in general, this idea of just allowing things to be is the way out of all the activity of the mind. The doing of the mind is the problem. And when we rest, we are undermining the idea of doing. And so much of the distractions in meditation, whether it's the thinking mind or the dull mind, or many other things as well, such as hearing the outside world, all of these things, very often, they are because there is a degree of suffering inside, and we want to distract ourselves. We're not really fully happy in the present. There's maybe a tension in the body, and that is why we should spend a lot of time just alleviating the tensions and the pains in the body. But it's also the discomfort of the mind itself. And so we need to find ways of letting go of that discomfort and finding a sense of joy in the mind, a sense of happiness, a sense of uplift. And this is where these recollections that the Buddha recommends come in. When you feel inspired about your own conduct, when you feel inspired by the fact that you are living well, when you feel inspired by the fact that you're giving the world a gift by your attitudes, by your virtue, by living in the right way. What a wonderful thing that is to do that, to support yourself and support the world by right action. And allow this to kind of feed into your mind in a positive sense. And in that way, dispelling some of the underlying discontent and problems that are there. The idea of remembering something that you have done, an act of generosity. And some of you are very kind people, and I am the recipient of that kindness every day that I'm here. And so rejoice in that. What a wonderful thing it is to be a giver in the world rather than a taker. And sometimes just the small little gifts that you do, small little things are very valuable. And you're showing your attitude by these small acts of kindness throughout the day and whenever else it is that you do these things. So bring these things to mind and allow that to dispel the any remaining suffering or problems and bring some clarity, joy, and brightness to the mind instead. And then as you gradually find a nice and stable mind, a mind with the right kind of attitude, a mind that is present in a positive kind of way, and you can just wait for the breath to arise. The breath is always there, and sometimes you just have to allow it through. And then when you allow it through, you're in a sense already doing the breath meditation. It's very important when you do the breath meditation not to control the breath, but to allow the breath to be. That means the breath will sometimes disappear, and then you just wait for the breath to return. But don't control it so that it is always present, because then it becomes uncomfortable and not really sustainable. The breath should be like an object that is far away. It should not be your breath, but just a breath. A bit like watching the sunset. When you watch the sunset, you don't control the sun. You don't control the clouds or the horizon. You allow everything to be. And so the breath is a bit like a sunset. It is something that doesn't belong to you. It is part of nature. And your job is simply to allow it to be and to be with it rather than to control it. In this way, you can make the breath into something very beautiful and delightful, like this soft, gentle thing that passes through you, but in the end has got nothing to do with you. In the end, something that you don't control. Okay, so once again, take a few moments just to review the meditation before you come out, just to try to understand the cause and conditions that make this process work. Thank you.